Through breeding and training on Winning Post this month, we've been following the journey of a thoroughbred, and now we've reached our final destination, Dubai.
Well, it's an emirate that boasts the tallest building in the world, so to stand out here takes some doing, but the Meydan Racecourse certainly does that. Let's go check it out.
It boasts the world's first five-star trackside hotel, also numerous restaurants and a museum.
Built in 2010, it was said to cost $1 billion. This place is colossal, and it really is a case of seeing is believing. The two-month-long Dubai Carnival will come to its conclusion here on World Cup night. Thousands of fans will pack into this grandstand, which, can you believe, is a mile long. All of this, then, is the vision and the dream of the Dubai ruling family.
When Dubai Millennium crossed the line in 2000 to win the World Cup in the Godolphin colours, a lifelong passion for Sheikh Mohammed was realised. But in order to maintain Dubai's presence at the very top of the sport, Meydan was conceived.
Your Highness, the racecourse is looking majestic this evening. With your passion for the sport, what was your idea? What did you want to create here?
Well, my love for the horses, you know, not only because they are beautiful and strong and beautiful, you know. And the Arab, you know, to love their horses and their falcon and their dogs. So the love for horses in my blood.
And it is a stunning race course. And on World Cup night, I imagine this place comes alive. What is so special about Dubai World Cup night?
What is special about Dubai World? I'll tell you. The racing in England, not many travel to Australia. And the racing in America, no money travel to England, to Europe, to race. So we made this race here, so everybody can come and compete with each other, so we know what's the best horse at that time.
Roger Varian's Interlac is likely to run in the World Cup, but before then, Battersea was back at Meydan looking to follow up on last month's victory.
Battersea, having started slow, at the midpoint of a race, wanted to go a stride quicker than room allowed him.
Battersea's drifted back to be worse than midfield.
Still thought he had a chance. He looked to be sat on a lot of horse. Didn't quite get the room over gaps when he needed them.
Star Empire third, then Battersea Meadow Creek, quarterback, Payne Magnus, Rio.
Picture how he's going to behave now if I send him to Australia or Hong Kong or back out here next year. So I think, yeah, very worthwhile experience.
A disappointing result for Roger, but he didn't have long to wait for another runner. On Super Saturday, in a dress rehearsal for the $5 million Shima Classic on World Cup night, Postponed was favourite in his first race for the yard.
Ready to run. Gates are back. Postponed joins in on the outside and is travelling sweetly. Postponed, the King George winner, is riding home for an easy win. Ratings told the tale.
I thought he looked great before the race tonight, and, you know, just a big relief that he's gone and won. Perhaps how he deserved to win.
To have a horse like Postponed going for one of the big races on the world's richest night of racing is something special.
Absolutely. I think it's what we all strive for, isn't it? Big runners on big days. And he's a big horse, and very much looking forward to it.
Well, mixed fortunes for Roger then in Dubai, but good that he ended on a high. And if you want to see more from Roger's training in the UK, behind the scenes in his yard, then do visit CNN.com. But here, all eyes are now on the Dubai World Cup at the end of March.
I am a winner when I see all these people here. And remember, we're bringing the horse back home. What I mean by that, I mean all the thoroughbred racing in the world, and all the tracks in the world are descending from the Arabic stallions. So therefore, something in my blood with that horse. So we want to bring the horse back home.
Well, that's it from here in Dubai. On next month's winning post, we'll be down under in Australia, in Sydney, for their autumn carnival. We'll see you then.